Hello and welcome to another Metal World Order. It's been a while since I've done one, but as you can see in the title, I want to talk about Mark the Shark Shelton, a founding member of the legendary kick-ass epic power metal band, Manila Road. Mark passed away at the age of 60 years old, Friday, July 27th, after performing in Germany at Headbangers Open Air, which is a festival there. They have quite a few metal festivals over in Germany, and that's one of them. It was confirmed about a day or so later that Mark died of a heart attack through the band on a live Facebook video. Vocalist Brian Patrick confirmed that, and that was a very uneasy video to watch. I can't imagine what the band's going through right now. They just lost a good friend. It still fucking sucks. I'm gonna read what was said in the live stream from Brian Patrick. This is kind of hard to read, to be honest with you. I just can't imagine what he went through. Last night, I was able to hold Mark in my arms until the paramedics got there. I comforted him. He felt no pain. He went quick. He suffered a heart attack. The stage was very hot last night. A lot of smoke. I was even struggling for a moment. And there was a couple moments I went to check on Mark to make sure he was doing okay. And he gave me the nod. Keep pounding, brother. He went out on top. That's rough. That is rough. That's rough. Mark the Shark Shelton, though, was a hell of a guitar player and vocalist. He did vocals as well. He was pretty unique with his guitar playing and his vocal style. He kind of had a gravelly sounding vocal style, but it wasn't too much like some bands can get. And it really fit the theme of Manila Road. They were a band that sung about literature, horror, mythology, fantasy, history. Now, I first heard about Manila Road a handful of years ago. I know I've gave a shout out to this forum many times on here, and that forum is Forces of Steel. And Painkiller, the owner, who I've talked to quite a bit, still talk to this day, off and on, showed me who they were. Now, granted, I knew the name, I just never listened to the music. And I finally did, and I was instantly hooked. I ended up going out and buying a few CDs. And of course, with the way technology is these days, you can go on YouTube and pretty much find almost every one of their albums. Manila Road did end up releasing 18 albums. The last album they did was To Kill a King, which came out in 2017, and it was a pretty damn good album. The first 8 albums from them, though, maybe even the first 9, in a 10-year span from 1980 to 1990, a lot of people love those albums. Some of their later albums, a lot of people love them. Some people are mixed on them. It kind of happens with a band that releases a ton of music. Thanks to Painkiller over at Forces of Steel, I got to check this band out and enjoy every minute of it. Now, I'm going to put a link in the description box below. Painkiller actually did an interview with Mark Shelton, and he actually got to see Manila Road live in Seattle, which is kind of something that doesn't happen very often. A band like that coming to the Pacific Northwest, or even the United States in general. But the thing about Manila Road, you would think, oh, they're probably from Germany or Sweden or something like that. No, they were from Wichita, Kansas, here in the United States. But they still didn't come up to the Pacific Northwest very often. Matter of fact, that might have been their only time. Now, Manila Road formed in 1977, and they did their first show in Wichita, Kansas. It actually created a bit of a stir in the music scene around there. Pretty much, they were just the only hard rock band or metal band around. You don't know about a ton of metal bands coming from Wichita, Kansas. And they did their own material, too, which was pretty cool. I know when a lot of bands start out, they play a lot of covers and stuff like that. Granted, I'm sure they did play a few covers, which is cool, but they did their own music. And Manila Road was a huge impact to the music scene in Kansas, especially for hard rock and heavy metal. There's a quote that came from 2015 in an interview with the Portland Mercury, which I'm guessing is a newspaper, I could be wrong, that Mark Shelton said this: "I never felt like I was too old for heavy metal. I'll be doing this till I die." And as far as I'm concerned, he went out on top. Now, I know what some people are thinking. Well, Manila Road's not really well known. I'm sure they only played in front of 100 people, 200 people. Screw all that bullshit. Manila Road was known in the heavy metal scene. That's the problem with a lot of metalheads. They won't look past what is popular. Sure, they're not selling out arenas. Sure, they're not playing arenas. But that shit doesn't matter. A good band is still a good fucking band. And Manila Road was a fucking great heavy metal band. And Mark Shelton is a heavy metal legend. Who knows what's going to happen with Manila Road? At this time, I think it's a bit early. I think the whole band is going to be mourning the loss of Mark for a while. It's just a damn shame. 60 years old is still a bit young. If you haven't listened to Manila Road, definitely go listen to it. If you like epic power metal, go out there and pick up the first 10 albums. any way you can. And then check out some of the later stuff, too. If I had to choose one album right now, and it's the first album I ever heard, Open the Gates. That album is fucking amazing, and one day I'll get around to reviewing it. Also, like I said, I will put that interview that Painkiller did with Mark Shelton. It's through the Forces of Steel forum, and it's a fucking great interview. Mark seemed like a down-to-earth, great guy, fun to talk to. He'd be like the type of guy that after a metal show, walk up with a beer and just have a beer and talk music. He was there to put on a show for the fans and enjoy every minute of it. And that's what's fucking awesome about these bands that are not mainstream. Anyways, that is it for this Metal World Order episode. My condolences and thoughts are with Mark Shelton's family, his bandmates, fans. This fucking sucks. It does. And wherever he's at out there, I'm sure he's got a guitar in his hand and just fucking kicking ass. I hope you enjoyed this Metal World Order episode. Thanks for watching.